Hey guys, so today we're going to be taking a look at the 18 liter Myth backpack from a company called STM Goods. And so I wasn't familiar with the company in the past, but they reached out to see if I'd be interested in featuring one of their bags on the channel. And so after doing a little bit of research on their site and seeing some of the different features that their bags had to offer, I was definitely intrigued, and they were kind enough to send a bag for me to test out. And I've been using it for the past month or so, and so far it's been a pretty solid little EDC and tech bag. Very nice minimal styling, and I'm excited to talk about how it compares to a lot of the other similar bags that we featured on the channel. So I want to thank the company for sending the bag for me to test out, and let's just jump in and take a closer look at the 18 liter Myth backpack from STM Goods. So starting out with the outside, the Myth bag definitely seems to have a modern and techie look. It seems to have been made to be a little bit more fashionable. It has some interesting color and fabric choices. It's a little bit less minimal than what I typically like to see. So as I was using this, I compared this a lot to the Air Day Pack, which is a similarly styled bag that's meant for minimal daily carry, but is definitely a lot more plain on the outside. It's just got an all black exterior. So a lot more going on this pack here. So not necessarily my style preference, but it might work better for people that don't want such a simple looking bag. And so this version of the bag is a combination of black and gray, but it is available in red and blue color waves as well. And regardless of the colors, the bag has a very sleek silhouette. It's very slim. It hugs your back very closely while you're wearing it. It comes in at about 18 liters. And it felt a little bit smaller than this to me. That was one thing that I really noticed while I was packing the bag out and wearing it, is that it always felt just slightly tight for my frame. I'm about 5'11 and a half. So typically this size of bag fits my frame well, but in this case, I felt like it was just a little bit tight and like I really had to squeeze the items that I typically want to pack with me on my day to day. I even had to leave a few of them out. So even though something like the Air Day Pack is listed at a little bit smaller volume than this, I felt that it was able to hold a little bit more. The Myth backpack is offered in a larger 28 liter capacity, so I'd definitely be curious to try that out and see how it compared. They both seem to have the same slick style. That one just has a few additional compartments. But if you're looking for just minimal daily carry and something that's gonna hug your back and be very easy and nimble to walk around with, the silhouette for this will definitely work well in that case. As far as the materials of the bag, it's made out of a durable polyester with a water-resistant coating. So as I've been wearing this while I've been walking around, it's definitely felt like it would keep my items protected from the elements. It doesn't feel quite as durable as something like the ballistic nylon that we've seen on other daily bags that we've checked out, but still a pretty solid feeling bag. I don't feel like it's gonna tear on me or anything like that. And one benefit from the polyester material is that it's a little bit lighter, so the bag comes in at just over 2 pounds, so it doesn't add a lot of extra weight to your back while you're wearing it with a lot of stuff. Continuing along the outside, the bag has just one logo here on the front for the STM Goods brand. The bag also includes some well-protected zippers for the different compartments that it has. I don't think these are YKK, but I do like to see that there's a nice water guard on the main zipper that kind of protects your laptop and tech accessories, and then all the other zippers are still provided with a nice amount of covering to help keep water out. Another interesting stylistic touch is the use of this webbing on the zipper pulls and the top handles. It's very tough feeling. It feels like it's gonna hold up well if you do get caught in some rain. It also offers a nice amount of grip and very easy to kind of pull the zipper pulls, but I just don't quite like the look, and I do wish that it had been either a little bit more thick or more padded just to make it a little bit more comfortable to hold. As you can see here, the handle is kind of narrow, so if you're holding it for a longer period of time through this, it could start to dig into your hand. While we're on the outside, I was sad to see that there is no external water bottle compartment. So if you want to carry a water bottle with you, you'll have to put it into the main area of the bag. So I'm always a little bit sad when bags don't include that, as I like to be able to reach down and grab my water bottle quickly. Moving on to the straps and the back paneling, this is definitely an area where the bag excelled. I really love how padded and comfortable the straps have been. They're nice and thick. On the inside, they have a nice meshing material to help prevent moisture from building up. The straps have a nice width to prevent the bag from digging into your shoulders when you're wearing it with a lot of weight. And then I really like the contoured shape here. This has felt great on my shoulders as I've been wearing it. In addition to the comfortable straps, the bag also has an adjustable sternum strap to help distribute the weight a little bit more. One thing that I really like about how the shoulder strap system was implemented here is at the top, the way this area comes out, it kind of wraps around the top of your shoulders, giving a very ergonomic feel to how this sits on your back. It reminds me a lot of how the Evergood CPL 24 kind of wrapped around your shoulders and it didn't go straight down. So really nice implementation here. This area also has a lot of additional padding to just help provide that extra bit of comfort. Continuing on with the back paneling, the bag definitely does a great job here of offering lots of comfort. The padding is nice and soft. It has this meshy material here to help prevent moisture from building up like we saw on the straps. There's also a nice amount of elevation, so some really great air channels here to help keep airflow moving while you're walking around. So just a really great job here on the back paneling. On the bottom, I really like how much support is offered in the lower back area to just help add that extra bit of comfort. One thing that I will note about the back paneling is that Similarly to what I mentioned earlier about the capacity, the bag just felt a little bit small on me. I believe that it would have been a lot more comfortable if I'd gotten a larger bag for my size, as sometimes the bottom of the bag came up a little bit higher than I would have liked. It was still very comfortable to wear, but just with my height, I wish it would have been a little bit longer. Another nice feature here on the back is this luggage pass-through that's directly integrated into the lumbar support area. So this is a great feature if you're traveling with an additional carry-on bag. You can just lay this onto your suitcase through the handle. It fits in there very easily. And this allows you to securely rest the bag on your suitcase so you can roll it around if you don't want to wear it while you're walking around the airport or something like that. And so jumping into the organizational areas of the bag, it has some nice quick access compartments on the front. The first one we'll jump into is this one at the top here. Very nice, simple compartment meant to hold something like your sunglasses. So currently what I have in here is my Ray-Bans with their case. What's nice about this compartment is that it does have a soft fleece lining on the inside, so I don't think I would have had to use my case if I wanted to just put them in there to save some space. This would also be a good spot for something like your phone. So a nice amount of space here. You can see that my hand can almost fit in there. Continuing along the front of the bag, there is another quick access compartment a little bit lower down. The first thing I'll call out about this compartment is that when the main compartment is completely full, it doesn't leave too much space in this area for thicker items. As you can see, the bag doesn't come up that much. And with the items that I currently have in here, it's really tightly packed. So a little bit harder to pull things out. So something to keep in mind as you're packing everything out. Inside this compartment, there is a little keychain loop and lanyard so that you can easily get to your keys. Currently what I have in here is my Gerber Shard, but just a nice simple plastic clip there that you can use to keep your stuff organized. Then I also have my portable hard drive with its case to keep it a little bit more protected. And so the other item that I have in here is a lightning cable to charge my phone. And then an interesting thing about this compartment is that it has a pass-through so that you can thread this through into the main area. So as we'll see in a little bit, I have a portable battery in there that's connected to this cable. So if I throw my phone in here, I can charge it while I'm on the go. And so the last area we're gonna take a look at is the main compartment, which has these nice zippers that go all the way down the side of the bag. The compartment opens up nice and wide. Reminds me a lot of the Timbuktu Division Pack, which we looked at a while back. And so I really like how with this style of opening, you can really see everything that's in the bag at once. I also like that it has these little guards on the side to prevent items from spilling out if you're just holding it up like this. And so as I mentioned a little bit earlier, even though this has 18 liters of capacity, this did feel a little bit smaller than some of the other similarly sized bags that we've looked at in the past. So I wasn't able to fit items like my Levitate portable standing desk and even something like a folder I chose to leave out just to make space for the other items that I thought were more important to carry with me. And so jumping into the items that I have here, the first thing is my Beats Solo Wireless 3 with their hard case. Next up, I have my water bottle that you've seen in all my other daily bag videos. As mentioned earlier, it's unfortunate that I couldn't put it on the outside, so I was able to find a space for it here in the main compartment, which I'm not crazy about just because it does share the space with the laptop, so if there's ever any spills, that's always a little bit of a concern. Next up, I have my GoRuck wired up, which has all my dongles and smaller tech accessories. And then the last thing here is my full-size Moleskine notebook. And so here you can get a better feel for the compartment when it's empty. So the bottom is really gonna show you just about how much volume you have to work with. And so moving on to some of the organizational options that are on the flap, there's two simple slip compartments here that you can use for bulkier accessories. Currently what I have in here is my Apple Magic Mouse. Next to that is another identically sized slip pocket which holds my Blue Pop portable Bluetooth speaker and power bank. So a nice amount of space in these zip compartments for bulkier items. And then at the moment I have this connected to the cable that we saw in the front quick access compartment. You can see the pass through here. So if I want to charge my phone, that cable comes into the front compartment here for easy access. In addition to being able to pass this cable through to the front quick access compartment, the main area also offers a nice bit of cable management. It has these orange clips here, which allow you to wrap a cable such as this around to prevent any tangling or to prevent the compartment from looking very messy. And then you can thread that charging cable here. If you have a tablet or an iPad or something like that, you can plug it in and use the battery to charge that as well. So a nice little touch with these clips here. If you're somebody who likes to keep everything charged throughout the day, this will definitely help prevent your bag from turning into a mess. While we're on the flap, the last thing I'll call out is that it does have this little interesting loop here that I guess you can use to clip something like your keys, or maybe I could have clipped the water bottle under here. I'm not entirely sure what the best way to use this would be, but still nice to have another place to clip accessories onto. Continuing on with the organization on the back, pulling lots of different slip pockets here. If you're somebody who likes everything to have its own spot, this is definitely going to be very helpful. So starting off here, there's a larger, simple slip compartment, similar to the ones that we saw on the flap, so I would have been able to put my mouse or my portable battery in here. I chose to leave it empty just to give more space to the other items that I had in the main area. Next to that, there's a few slots if you have something like a pen or a stylus that you want to carry with you. Next to those is an interesting little compartment that's meant to hold your AirPods, so you can see that they fit in there very nicely. If you don't have AirPods, I'm sure you could fit a variety of other cases or smaller accessories. Maybe if you have some earplugs, you can throw those in easily. There's a little slip compartment behind that, which I'm not sure how you would be able to use it. It's very small and thin, and I would rather just leave that space for the AirPod compartment. Next up, there's a larger and flatter slip compartment behind those where I currently just have my field notes notebook. This could also be a good area for something like your passport. So nice amount of space here, goes about the length of my fingers. Again, it's always interesting with these organizational areas that have so many pockets on top of each other, how much you can actually use each one. So you have to be a little bit strategic about how you pack everything out. Next up, there is a larger simple sleeve area, which might be good for something like a larger notebook, or maybe my folder with some papers would have fit in here comfortably. I don't know why there's so many different sleeves and slip compartments behind that. There is something that I would imagine is a little bit more for your tablet. It has a slight amount of padding. It's a little bit thicker than the rest of the slip pockets in the compartment. So definitely an area where I would want to put my tablet. And so currently what I have in here is my iPad mini 2. I think I could definitely fit up to a 10-inch tablet in here comfortably. And so it is nice that this tablet sleeve is elevated off the bottom of the ground and that it does have a little bit more padding. It unfortunately doesn't have any sort of fleece lining or anything like that, which would have been a nice touch to help prevent against scratching, but still nice to have a dedicated area where you can reach down and easily grab it. As I was saying, the only issue is that because this is for your tablet, I wouldn't want to fill all these compartments up with a lot of stuff and possibly have things pressing down on the screen. So I don't really think having this many compartments on the flap will be that useful ultimately if you want to carry your tablet and your laptop with you. And speaking of the laptop area, that's the last thing we're going to talk about here. Really nice laptop compartment implemented in this backpack. Definitely one of the strong points. It has a nice fleece lining on the back. It's meant to hold up to a 15-inch laptop. So currently what I have in here is my 13-inch MacBook Pro. And so now with the compartment empty, you can see about how much it comes up. Nice solid padding on the back, fleece lining on both sides. So really like how well this was implemented here. And then a nice bonus is that the company really paid attention to protecting your device from drops. And so in order to do that, they really made sure to not only elevate the compartment and add the fleece lining, but also to keep it away from the side. So you can see here that the compartment is very well separated on all the corners from areas that they call the drop zone. So if you happen to drop your laptop or when you place it down, what they've gone is and tried to remove the laptop compartment from areas that are typically vulnerable to contact with the ground. Really like how this was implemented here. I do feel like it adds a nice amount of extra protection. So really nice job on this laptop compartment overall. I wish more companies had systems like this, and just a great job in general in this main compartment of trying to provide some unique features and offering a nice amount of organization for all the different things that you need to carry with you on your day to day. And so to wrap up, I've enjoyed testing out the 18-liter Myth backpack over the past month or so. Although it's a little bit smaller than I would have liked, the bag does have some really interesting features. It's been very comfortable to wear, and it has a nice slim silhouette that's gonna work well in a variety of environments. And so you can purchase the Myth backpack for about $120 on the STM site and on Amazon. At $120, I do think the price of the bag is a little bit high, especially considering how many great daily bags are available at this price point. And so as I was using this, the first one that came to mind was the Air Day Pack, which has been one of my favorite minimal daily carry bags. It has a nice, great style, very solid build quality, some good organizational options, and it comes in at a very similar price point to this. You can get that for about $125, and I do think the build quality on that's gonna be a little bit better. It holds a little bit more stuff, and I just really like the look. Another option that came to mind as I was using this was the standard Luggage Co. Daily Backpack. And that was a very solid, professional looking bag that works well as a backpack, as a shoulder bag, as a briefcase. It has a very slim silhouette, much like this one. It comes in at the same price point, coming in at around $120. The bags are made out of similar materials. I prefer the look and organizational options of that bag a little bit more, but this bag is gonna be slightly more comfortable. Again, the laptop area in this bag is a little bit better. It has that fleece lining, but if you're looking for a bag that's gonna be a little bit more versatile or maybe has a different look, the standard Luggage Co. Daily is gonna be a great option to check out in the same price range. Another bag this reminded me of was the Timbuktu Division Pack, which has been one of my favorite kind of business professional looking slim backpacks, especially with the Timbuktu brand and quality. I really love how comfortable that bag is. It has a really great look, minimal organizational options. It has a similar main area that opens, not completely flat, but wide so that you can see everything that's on the inside. So very similar layout, in my opinion, to this bag. It's gonna come in at a pretty close price point as well, at around that $100, $120 range. And I do think that bag has a slightly better build quality. It has the YKK zippers, and overall, I've always had a great experience with Timbuktu bags. So if you're looking for a professional looking bag with similar organizational options, the Timbuktu division is gonna be a very good alternative to this. The next bag this reminded me of was the Incase Compass backpack. And so we looked at that one a while back. That was a very simple kind of everyday bag that had some nice organizational options. That bag doesn't feel quite as well made as this one. It's not gonna be as comfortable. The laptop area doesn't offer quite as much protection, but it does have a nice fleece lining. It has a very simple, nice style. And that one's gonna come in at under $100. So if you're looking for a solid daily bag alternative that's gonna be a little bit less expensive, but slightly less durable than this, I definitely recommend you check out the video that we did for the Incase Compass backpack in the past. And then while we're talking about Incase bags, some other options that might be good to check out that are in a similar style to this would be something like the Incase Icon line of bags. They have a few different versions of the bag depending on how much capacity you need. On the channel, we've looked at the Incase Icon Slim, which had a very similar style to this. It's a little bit bigger. They also have a light version of that bag, which is closer in size to this one. So just a great alternative. I've really enjoyed using the Incase Icon line of bags over the past couple of years. They've held up well. They have some nice organizational options. They might be a little bit more expensive depending on if you get them on Amazon or on their site. But if you're looking for something similar to this with maybe a more minimalistic style, those may be good options to check out. And then the last bags I'll mention are the Lepacker and Tiger New budget bags that we've looked at in the past. There's a few different options that we've checked out. I'll make sure to link to the videos that we've done for those in the past. Those bags come in at about $30 to $40, and they're very similar stylistically to this type of bag. They're just minimal kind of tech and everyday bags. They're definitely not gonna be as well made or as comfortable as this bag here. But if you wanna save a little bit of money and are looking for something in a similar style, those may be good options to consider as well. But with all that being said, the Myth backpack does a good job of holding its own against those bags and trying to offer some different features. As I mentioned during the video, the laptop compartment is one of the best that we've looked at. It does a really great job of protecting your device. I was also impressed with how comfortable the bag was to wear. So really great job on the harness system and the back paneling. And so if you're just looking for a comfortable, minimal, and stylish bag, this is definitely gonna be a good option to check out. And so I'm curious to hear if you guys had heard of STM Goods in the past or if you've used any of their other bags. Definitely let me know in the comments. And I want to go ahead and thank the company again for sending the bag for me to test out. And if you guys found this video useful, please go ahead and give us a like below. And if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming videos. And thank you guys so much.